The music is different here. The vibrations are different. It would affect their vibrations for the better, of course. Another place in the universe, up under different stars. That would be where the altered destiny would come in. Equation-wise, the first thing to do is to consider time as officially ended. We work on the other side of time. We bring them here through either isotope teleportation, transmolecularization, or better still, teleport the whole planet here through music.
For our part, you will find that at first, toward the idea of accelerating toward contact, open contact, both with the Yael, the hybrid race that will be the first to have open contact with you, followed by another, and then us in third place, as you say, since we just love. Here's the key word, the number three. The acceleration of that contact, there will be, after the crossing of this threshold, more and more and more and more. Dream communication with us.
The world was filled with dreamers, the servants of the sleeping god Cthulhu, summoned by blood and bounded by salt, the enemy of all that
and
lived.
And others like us, those contacts that have already occurred, it acts for us like a barometer, like a gauge, like a measuring device, because the more you remember the contacts you've already had that have been deliberately forgotten, the closer we can gauge how ready you are for more contact. So the rate at which you remember the contacts you've already had will help accelerate the rate at which contact can happen in your reality. Recently, in a communication, in a transmission that we had with certain members on your planet, a great shift occurred in the vibrational energy of your world and ours. And this indicates, as our ship comes closer and closer to the surface of your world, again, another barometer, another measuring device, that indicates you are that much closer. We are that much closer to contact occurring. And that's a big drop. That's a large drop. It is up to each and every one of you to become more sensitized to this vibration. And some of you will find that in order to accelerate your energy, and in a sense, purge yourself of whatever toxins are representative of the old vibration.
Now to the surprise decision that stopped the supersized drink ban the entire country was watching. The ban against sugary drinks larger than 16 ounces was set to go into action today in New York City. At the last minute, a judge struck down the controversial new rule. ABC's Gio Benitez is here with the latest. A lot of eyes on this, Gio.
This morning, New Yorkers won't have to make that cataclysmic change of ordering only small sugary drinks. Just hours ago, they were bracing for the big drink apocalypse.
This is one of the last ones.
Because it's the last day.
Then a stunning reversal late Monday. A state judge striking down that ban on sugary drinks larger than 16 ounces. The judge siding with outraged. How much sugar is in a glass of soda? Well, in 16 ounces, you'll find the equivalent of 27 cubes of sugar. 27 cubes of sugar. But some New Yorkers say having the freedom to choose their own drinks is
well, sweet.
It's good.
It's good.
Let people make their own decisions.
Supersized drinks like this are the target of a first-of-its-kind ban that New York Mayor Michael Bloomberg wants to impose. His proposal prohibits sugary drinks larger than 16 ounces.
Outlawing salt from restaurant food. It could happen in New York, home to some of the world's best restaurants and chefs. A new proposed bill would ban salt use in New York restaurants and impose a $1,000 fine on any chef.
On a possible ban on those menthol cigarettes, the FDA's
smoking ban. The weekend is here.
Non-smokers will soon be able to breathe easy no matter where they eat under sweeping new anti-smoking laws. Lighting up will be banned in all outdoor dining areas in 3 years and within months in public spaces like playgrounds.
Soon, lighting up near playgrounds will be anything but child's play. It'll be an offence with fines of up to $550.
Some of you may need to detoxify yourself and purge yourself and cleanse yourselves and empty out things that you've been holding on to, which may have certain physical manifestations. I think some of you know what I mean. But the more you hold on, the more you resist, the more you keep holding on to things that don't belong in this vibration, the rougher and the bumpier the journey may be. So let go. Let go. Relax with it. And it will balance out.
Single one of you to do at this time is simply allow yourselves to get relaxed and get comfortable and tune in to the vibrations of Sirius.
So that letting go of all those things that have nothing to do with that vibration will happen, will come up emotionally, will come up physically, will come up energetically, in a variety of ways. Fear not. It's par for the course. So just relax, take a deep breath, and find that you will be able to ingest those simple things, water and air, and a simple diet that will begin to sustain you through this and stabilize you through this. Keeping it simple, keeping it clean, and just take it a day at a time, and everything will work out, because everything is working out, because everything has already worked out, because everything already exists.
He's banned smoking, which now is being done around the world, so why not?
Now, why is it that New York City wants to ban people from having more than 16 ounces of soda? Why do they want you to cut down on your salt intake? You know, it just seems to me that something's really interested in what the makeup of your blood is. And I'm not saying that they're vampires, blah, blah. I'm saying that there's something really weird that they want people's blood to react a certain way.
For Philadelphia's smoking ban, the weekend is here, and so is the smoking ban in all workplaces, bars, and restaurants.
I find it very interesting that they would tell you that you can't drink X amount of soda, and that Australia wants to boot up cigarettes to $100 a package. You know, smoke has a very, very odd effect on things. And I know from studying over years that in a lot of this, even in voodoo, that they'll use smoke to run spirits out. See, this is what the abyss is. They're spirits.
And I remind you, manifestation is not something that you pull from somewhere else to you. Manifestation is the realization and the harmonizing with the vibration of what already exists here with you, that you simply do not see yet because it is invisible to the vibrational level on which you operate. So by simply matching the frequency of what is already here, it becomes visible, and you call it a manifestation. But it's all here, all of it, right here, right now. The whole process you are going through is simply learning to match the frequency that allows you to perceive and experience that which is already here.
They're everywhere.
It is all here. You have it all. You just can't see it all yet. You just can't experience it all yet because you're not the vibration of those things yet. But that's all right. The process is, the journey itself is the destination.
That's what we are. Spare parts.
The body snatchers.
And as your eyes open, outer and inner, you will discover more and more surprises after the crossing of this threshold about who you are. One of the other things that will occur after this acceleration is the opening of your eyes to realizations and recognitions of yourself that will surprise you. You will suddenly be feeling the changes and shifts in your own identity and waking up into the idea of, this is who I am. I am no longer that. That is someone else, truly someone else. This is who I am. It is similar to the idea, the experience we have talked about when you physically die. It's like waking up from a dream. And even though the dream may have seemed very real, when you wake up in the morning, you go, well, that was a dream. And this is who I really am. This is what's real. Dying is like that in the sense that you wake up into spirit and go, this is who I really am. And the physical life was, in a sense, a dream. You will experience those mini deaths, those mini births throughout this transformation.
On this earth right now, dark forces that are from somewhere else and that they are playing out some kind of a war and some kind of a control factor is being to save mankind during this transition.
There is no death. It is only a transition to a different sphere of consciousness.
Is a crisis in consciousness. Is a crisis in consciousness.
Especially when you really begin to accelerate on the other side of the threshold date, on the other side of the nexus point. You will have a series of soul quakes where you will suddenly jar yourself into the recognition of suddenly being who you really are. And the old identity will begin to be sloughed off like old clothing. And you will actually feel like you are stepping out of it, looking back and going, I was that, but I am not that. This is who I am. More and more and more, this will occur as you accelerate beyond the nexus point that we are all going through together. It's a very exciting time. We can see where you're headed. Trust us. To become fully human is what allows you to go beyond, is what allows you to choose the next idea, the next expression of your being, be it something that is human or otherwise. So of my oversoul are having simultaneous incarnations at the same time.
My oversoul are having simultaneous incarnations at the same time.
For me to accept, say, oh yeah, I come from the star. I'm a star child. You know, the aliens had me, gave me life. No, they did not, because they're fallen angels. If a fallen angel had gave birth to me or made me, then I would be like a giant and I would be evil, because their DNA would be in my DNA. No, unacceptable.